each and every one of you that came out tonight. Listen, enjoy it. Like I said, we want to welcome you. Just want you to feel at home here in God's house here. That's the main thing. There's always, you can always find comfort in God's house. So we want you to definitely feel like you're at home. And we want you to just enjoy the big Lord wills the choir come. Get a few minutes to sing our guitar. And we appreciate you. So if you would tonight, we'd like to bow our heads tonight. Let's go to the Lord and word of prayer before we open up. Most precious Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you, God, for this day you bless us with. Father, we thank you for each and every one that's here tonight, God. We thank you for each and every one that's had a part in this. Father, Lord, I pray, Lord, that you just please, that you put your hand around, Lord, that you just bless in a mighty way, God. God, I pray, Lord, that you bless each and every one that's here, Lord, from the top of their head, Lord, to the bottom of their feet. God, we just ask you, Lord, that you come down and be with us tonight, Lord, that you let each and every one enjoy. Father, we pray, Lord, that that you just bless, Lord, in this season, God. And God, we thank you, Lord, most of all, Lord, for what you've done for us. We thank you for your son, Jesus, Lord, that you sent for each and every one of us, God. We thank you for salvation, God, that you offer us. God, we love you, we praise you, and we thank you. And we ask this all in your son, Jesus' precious and holy name, this city. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
On behalf of the choir and Sister Jackie, we welcome each of you here tonight. Our cantata, Sing Gloria, talks about God's love for all of us. It emphasizes the hope we can all have in Him. And it talks about His holy presence, Emmanuel, God with us. Wow, can you imagine our Creator, our Savior, our soon-coming King right here with us tonight? We're excited, and we hope you're excited too. We're going to sing from our heart, for Christ is the reason we sing. The first song is a carol medley. You know these songs and the words we projected, so we're inviting you all to sing along with us. Praise the Lord and get into Christmas spirit. Thank you so much for being here. Merry Christmas, and may God bless you.
It's Christmas. Ring the bells, sound the trumpets, proclaim the glory of Christ who has come to dwell among his people. Christmas season to rejoice, and what a better way to celebrate than to sing.
Sing, sing, sing. This is the time for rejoicing. Come, let your voice.
before the angel Gabriel's visit to Mary, God's people were already experiencing what it was like to live in expectation. The writings of the prophets would foreshadow the events to come as the world longed for a Redeemer. Centuries of hope and wonder would pass as they waited for God to fulfill His covenant with Israel. It represents the very foundation of our religion. Hope enables us to live in the confidence that His word is true and He will not forsake His own. And so it was, in the fullness of God's time, beneath the stillness of the Bethlehem skies, the hope of the world was born. Scripture tells us they wrapped Him in swaddling clothes and laid Him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you. Peace, goodwill toward you. comfortment shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end.
Thank you.
story of Christmas down to one word, it would have to be love. For nothing short of love would compel a father to give his only begotten son so that whoever believed in him could live forever. Only love would permit a king to come as a pauper, to exchange the glory of heaven for the agony of the cross. Only love would look beyond who we have been and what we have done and see something worth redeeming. Yes, love truly is the story of Christmas.
Oh,
It's hard to believe when we think about it, that the hope of this whole world rested on a small baby, born in a manger, in the middle of nowhere. Just a small baby. But because of that baby, everything changed. Because of that baby, there's hope now where there was no hope before. Because of that baby named Jesus, there's now a possibility for me and you to go to heaven. Whereas before, it was very slim. But now, because of what he done, because of this baby that was born in this manger, because the world didn't want him. The world didn't want to have anything to do with him. But God loved us so much that he gave us his son. That he would pay an ultimate price that me and you wasn't able to pay. See, I'm not worthy to pay for my sin. I can't live good enough. I can't be good enough. But this baby that came to us named Jesus, he was worthy in all rights. Blameless. Praise God. Blameless in all things. He was perfect. The perfect lamb. Up until that time, we gave animal sacrifices. But all it could do was stay our sins for 1 year. But Jesus came, and everything changed. Suddenly, praise God, there was a hope in this dark world. Suddenly, there was light where no light had ever been. Suddenly, there was a chance for a sinner like me to get to know this man named Jesus. Not only to get to know him, but to be part of his family. To become one, praise God, with Jesus Christ. To know him as my Savior. To be able to call out on him when things are bad. It's weird when times get hard. To have this man named Jesus, that even though I can't look and see him, I always know he's there. Even though I can't reach out and grab him, he always has a hold of me. Everything changed on that night when Jesus Christ was born. Now, we celebrate Christmas for a lot of different reasons, but sometimes we get all caught up in the glitz and the glamour. We get caught up in the package and the bowls and the trees and the ornaments that we hang in. We think that's Christmas. No, that's not Christmas. Christmas is a baby that came from heaven. That his whole purpose was to save the world. That's what Christmas was. So when you leave here tonight, if you take nothing else away from this whole thing that they've done tonight, what a beautiful job they've done. But if you take nothing else away from this, I hope you take the fact that there was a baby that came, and his name was Jesus. Through him, there was hope for this lost and dying world. Through him, today, over 2,000 years later, there's still hope for each and every one of us. You can take a lot of things away from a man, and he can still survive. But if you take his hope away, what a bleak existence it is. Jesus Christ is a lively hope. The Bible says not just a hope, but a lively hope. I don't serve a dead God. I serve a living God. Now, they've done an awesome job. The songs told the story, everything you needed to know, that he came and died for me and you. But I don't want to let you go tonight until I close our eyes and we have a little word with the Lord and I give you a chance. There may be one of you in here that don't know Jesus as your Savior. 15 years ago, God saved me. I didn't go to church that morning to be saved. I went to church that morning because somebody invited me. I didn't go looking for a Savior, but there was a Savior came looking for me. Tonight, you may have not came here looking for a Savior, but there was a Savior here that's looking for you. I want you to remember that you can have everything in this world,
If you was blessed enough to have all the fortune in the world, and you never wanted for anything, not food, not drink, not clothing, not shelter, money can almost even buy happiness for a little while. But if you never wanted for anything, I want you to know something. When it comes time to close your eyes for the last time, there's one thing that you may not have that you need. And you need more than any amount of money that you've ever had, any amount of clothing that you've ever had, any amount of food, or even the air that you breathe. Because when we close our eyes for the last time, we need this man named Jesus. So no matter what you have in this world, if you don't have him, you're lacking. You don't have the life that you're supposed to have. You don't know the love that he can give. And you don't know the peace that he brings. If you're saved in here tonight, you know what these songs was about. You failed them. But if you did, if you're lost, you may not know. The Bible says that those who don't know that it's Jesus Christ's foolishness. But to those who believe, praise God. So tonight, I'm going to give you an opportunity. You say, well, there's all kinds of people here. Know these people. I would hate to go to the front and bow my knee. The Bible says that every knee will bow and every tongue will confess. Now you may not bow your knee on this side, but when you have to bow your knee, it's too late. I want to go to heaven and stand before Jesus as he only my Savior, not my judge. And I want to give you that opportunity tonight. Jesus loves you. If you would, bow your heads with me. Most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for this season. We thank you, Lord, for what your Son Jesus done for each and every one of us. We thank you, Lord, for that lively hope that you've given us, God. We thank you, Lord, for the opportunity, Lord, to get to know you. God, I ask you, as we pray in secret, God, I ask you, Lord, if there's plenty in here that's lost, that's undone, that don't know you as their Savior. Let them know, Lord, that they need you more than they need anything else in this world. That they need you more than they need their next breath. God, I pray, Lord, that you call to their heart, that you speak to their soul. Let them know that they need you, Lord. If they need a Savior, that this baby that these songs talked about, this man, this Emmanuel, he's alive and well, and he's still changing lives today. Let them know that they need Jesus Christ more than they need anything else in this world. I love you, and I thank you. We thank each and every one for coming. I pray, God, that you bless everyone that's here, Lord. That you bless them, mighty Lord. That you bless them as they leave. Take care of them, watch over them, protect them. Bless their holiday season, Lord. This Christmas season, Lord, I pray, Lord, that you'd enrich it in each and every home. But God, most of all, let them remember what this season's about. Father, we love you and praise you. We thank you for all that, Lord Jesus, precious name. Amen. Now, before you depart tonight,